and let nothing you dismay. Here's wood enough to set each fireplace blazing on this day. And evergreens to decorate and festively display. Oh, times of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
While shepherds kept them watching o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light.
Well, that's what we were doing. This is what we looked like, and those were some of the songs people were singing at Christmas time around the turn of the century here in the United States. Life was simpler then. But with the dawning of a new century and all the excitement, it seemed to be a virtual state of euphoria in the land about plans for the future and predictions that had been made. Little did anybody realize how great some of those changes were going to be. Right after the turn of the century, they discovered oil. Here in Texas, it was over at Spindletop. The Wright brothers finally got it off the ground up at Kitty Hawk when they flew their flying machine. And everybody was singing, "Meet me in St. Louis, Louis, meet me at the fair." It was the World's Fair, the one responsible for introducing us to two major changes. One, a rather peculiar sounding treat called an ice cream cone. The other, a novel but revolutionary contraption, that wonder, the automobile. Oh, the invention of the automobile probably brought about more changes in lifestyle to people worldwide than anything else. When Henry Ford's Model T began to roll off the assembly line, they nicknamed him the Tin Lizzie. They had a whopping price tag of $350, and they brought a whole new sound to Christmas caroling.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. Jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Well, now man could be as mobile as he dared, and plenty of them dared. Do you have any earthly idea why they got traffic lights? Well, it was because so many pedestrians were getting in the way of motorists. They complained about them all the time, so they invented traffic lights for pedestrian safety. In 1910, Thomas Edison invented talking pictures. The Panama Canal was completed, joining the waters of the Atlantic and the Pacific Oceans. In 1920, women won the right to vote, ending their 81-year-long struggle. Now they were emancipated for all sorts of things. They joined the workforce, they bobbed their hair, and they shortened their skirts. Change and prosperity were on a rampage in the 20s. Charles Lindbergh went winging his lonely way across the Atlantic. Man of War was champion on the turf. Rin Tin Tin and Rudolph Valentino prevailed on the silver screen. A general sense of happiness was everywhere. In fact, just an awful lot of good-natured foolishness went on. Of all the fads and fashions that came about, one in particular swept the nation like a storm. But how quickly things went from boom to bust. All that happiness and prosperity came to a screeching halt on Black Thursday, October the 24th, 1929, the day the stock market began its five-day plunge. 30s and the Great Depression. Now Americans got introduced to bread lines and soup kitchens, bank failures, farm foreclosures, soaring unemployment. Sounds a lot like 1993. Got a lot of other things in the 1930s as well. Shirley Temple, the Empire State Building, a federal gasoline tax of a penny a gallon. We got the Golden Gate Bridge. We got King Kong. We got nylon. We got Social Security. Something in Fort Worth, Texas called a washateria. Superman. We got the Wizard of Oz and Gone with the Wind. Musically speaking, the 30s was a heyday for songwriters. I mean, they gave us songs in those days that allowed the fellow who was down and out to look on the bright side of things with a hope for the future. How in the world could anybody have the blues when they were hearing songs like these?
I got rhythm, I got music, I got my gal, who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, I got my gal, who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more? Every time it rains pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? will find your fortunes falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear that bitter pat? And that happy tune is your step. Just direct your feet to the sunny, sunny side of the street. And remember, 'cause when you're smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, baby, the whole songs that came out of the 1930s, though, one in particular really tugged at the heartstrings of every American. You see, Americans still had a great love for God and a deep abiding affection for this wonderful country of ours. Americans needed this song because they and the rest of the world would spend the next decade at war.
Right.
World War II forced us as a nation to have to grow up. And we needed that maturity for the onslaught of the fast-changing 50s. We added two more states, Alaska and Hawaii. Now there are 50 stars on our nation's flag. We began to dig bomb shelters. Folks began to see flying saucers. Sputnik and John Glenn orbited the Earth. All the girls wanted to look like Marilyn Monroe. The guys wanted to be like James Dean. Everybody liked Ike and Douglas MacArthur. They wore 3D glasses at the movies. They wore coonskin caps. They learned to chew chlorophyll gum. Also learned to twirl a hula hoop. Well, some of them did. Folks began to move to suburbia so they could sit down and watch American Bandstand on their black and white 12-inch TV sets. And everything was cool, man, cool. But you know, perhaps the biggest change of all in the 1950s was in our music.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. Blue, blue, blue.
In the 1990s, watching this old century as it begins to slowly wind down. Frankly, it looks most of the time like it's winding up so tight it's about to break. All of us seem to be as busy as little gerbils in our cages, making plans, hustling, working, praying, as we look toward the dawning of the 21st century. With it all, if we really think about it, we realize that music still plays a very vital part in all of our lives. We do marvel at the continuous evolutionary process music goes through. Tonight, you're going to hear some of the most wonderful music ever written. Some of it traditional, some of it hot off the presses, and all of it beautiful. It is with great joy we present to you now, in concert, the combined bell choirs, the orchestra and choir of Houston's First Baptist Church.
Praise the Lord. Man.
Yet feel the bell.
Have you heard the sound of the angel voices ringing out so sweetly, ringing out so clear?
Have you seen the star shining out so brightly as a sign from God that Christ our Lord is here?
Have you heard the news that they bring from heaven to the humble shepherds who have waited long? Gloria in excelsis Deo, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Hear the angels sing their joyful song. He is come in peace in the winter stillness, like a gentle snowfall in the gentle
come in love as the child of Mary in a simple stable. We have seen his birth.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Hear the angels singing peace on earth.
Ooh.